Be not afraid, only believe. You cannot walk in faith and in fear at the same time. Faith is a spirit given to us by God, whilst fear is a spirit that God has not given us. For God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. Fear can rob you of many good things in life. The difference between the successful and the unsuccessful is largely determined by their faith. One believes he can have anything, whilst another person is afraid of anything. Beloved, I want you to know that whatever you are afraid of now is afraid of you. Fear affects people's sound mind. Fear affects love negatively. The Word of God says, there is no fear in love. Perfect love casts out fear. He who fears is not yet perfected in love. Fear brings torments. Fear can cause someone to sin. So our Lord Jesus Christ saw a situation that looks humanly impossible, and from all indications is supposed to cause someone to fear. But he comes and says, fear not, only believe. This account is an account of a ruler called Jairus, whose daughter was sick, and the Bible says, now when Jesus had crossed over again by boat to the other side, a great multitude gathered to him, and he was by the sea. And behold, one of the rulers of the synagogue came, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet and begged him earnestly, saying, my little daughter lies at the point of death. Come and lay your hands on her, that she may be healed, and she will live. So Jesus went with him, and a great multitude followed him and thronged him. I don't know who is sick in your family or among your friends, but I see the Lord laying his hands on them to heal them. Whoever is lying at the point of death, a miracle is coming in Jesus' name. God will touch them, and they shall not die, but live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. The story continues that as Jesus was still attending to other people and healing them, some people came and said to Jairus, your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further? As soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he said to the ruler of the synagogue, do not be afraid, only believe. At this stage, Jairus might have felt afraid, demoralized, and traumatized. But Jesus looked at him and said, do not be afraid, only believe. I don't know what you are currently battling now, but God says, do not be afraid, only believe. With men, your situation may look hopeless, but with God, there is hope. God does not see as men see. Men are superficial, but God is supernatural. I see the supernatural hands of God coming upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jesus immediately drove out the naysayers and the unbelievers, and then commanded the supernatural, and the one who was dead came back alive. Faith causes dry bones to live again. Faith makes a way where there seems to be no way. And he permitted no one to follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. Then he came to the house of the ruler of the synagogue and saw a tumult and those who wept and wailed loudly. When he came in, he said to them, why make this commotion and weep? The child is not dead, but sleeping. And they ridiculed him. But when he had put them all outside, he took the father and the mother of the child and those who were with him and entered where the child was lying. Then he took the child by the hand and said to her, Talita kumi, which is translated, little girl, I say to you, arise. Immediately the little girl arose and walked, for she was 12 years of age, and they were overcome with great amazement. Beloved, I want you to make friends with people who believe and who can stand with you in faith in the midst of difficulties. Jesus had 12 disciples, but he always moves with Peter, James, and John. What a great encouragement to have someone who can believe God with you and stand by you in prayer to see that things turn out for the best. Today, instead of weeping over that situation, choose to believe. If crying will make you believe and not fear, then it is okay. Faith doesn't call things the way they are. Faith calls things the way they should be. Faith calls things that be not as though they were. Jesus said, "She is not dead, but sleeping." Faith is a spiritual weapon that will be underrated by the unbelieving. They will ridicule you because of your faith, but faith will always prove your mockers wrong. Faith brings amazing results. Jesus by faith said unto the little child, "I say to you, little child, arise." And the child arose and walked. Anything in your life that has been down, I see it rising in the name of Jesus Christ. Your business will rise again. You will become joyful in the God of your salvation. God will put your mockers to shame in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will not organize a pity party, but you will organize a praise party in Jesus' name. Amen. To achieve maximum results, believing must precede seeing. In John chapter 20, when Jesus resurrected, he appeared to some of the disciples and proclaimed the peace of God on them and breathed the Holy Spirit on them. However, one of the disciples called Thomas wasn't there. And when they told him the Lord resurrected, he doubted. Now Thomas, called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said to him, "We have seen the Lord." So he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Thomas was looking to see the evidence before he would believe, but faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Many have given up. Many have missed out on the greater good because, like Thomas, nothing seems to be evident to them from the start. The unbeliever wants to see something before they believe, but in Christ, believing is seeing. Let the weak say, "I am strong." So one of the days, Jesus appeared to the disciples with Thomas present. And Jesus said unto him, "Reach your finger here and look at my hands, and reach your hand here and put it into my side. Do not be unbelieving, but believing." And Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Thomas, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." God says, "Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. Do not be unbelieving, but believing." Jesus says, "Did I not say to you that if you would believe, you will see the glory of God?" You need to believe first before you can see the glory of the Lord. You need to believe to see the supernatural hand of God. Be strong and of good courage. Do not fear nor be afraid of them, for the Lord your God, he is the one who goes with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. Deuteronomy chapter 31 verse 6. God wants you to trample over fear and be courageous. God will never leave you nor forsake you. And the Lord, he is the one who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. Do not fear nor be dismayed. Anything done in faith has the backing of the Lord. Faith is what pleases the Lord. Faith is what obtains the promises of God. May God help you to overcome all your fears in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May you walk in faith all the days of your life. In Jesus' name, amen.